Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the Madden 20 Ultimate Team video, and today we have some Madden 21 news. We got all of the ratings of like the top 10 players from each team about, I think is what it is. It might be like top 10 or everyone above 80 for every team. I don't know exactly. I know this article was released a couple days ago. I know I haven't been uploading recently. Sorry, my birthday was the 15th, so I kind of just took a little bit of a break and enjoyed time with family and friends for my birthday, but I'm back now. It should be regular uploads, should be more quiz videos, tier lists, and maybe some 2K coming out, and maybe some gameplay in Madden if you guys really want to see that. So leave me down below what you guys want to see in the comment section. But before we get into the video, guys, make sure you guys drop a like down below and subscribe when nobody's on if you guys are enjoying the videos and you don't want to miss any coming up in the future. But as you guys can see, we got all 32 teams right here. We're just going to go over every team and their best player. We got Khalil. We're going to start from the bottom. So we got Cody Whitehair and Charles Leno Jr. at 81. That's cool. Robert Quinn at 82. Roquan Smith at 83. Eddie Goldman at 84. Kyle Fuller at 85 seems a little low. Kyle Fuller is pretty underrated. He's a pretty good corner. He makes it 88. Feels about right. Allen Robinson feels a little low at 89. He was a very good receiver last year. Eddie Jackson at 89 feels about right. And then Khalil Mack at 97 feels about right as well. Sorry if I'm talking a little weird. I just ate some food and I'm just like, you know, got that after food feeling. Moving on to the Bengals, we got Jesse Bates, who I definitely think he's way underrated. He deserves to be higher than a 79. Vaughn Bell at 79 feels about right. Carl Lawson at 80 feels right. William Jackson 81, a little bit low, but it's fine. Carlos Dunlap at 82 is about right. Tyler Boyd in 83, a little underrated. I like Tyler Boyd as a receiver a lot. DJ Reader, 84 feels about right. AJ Green at 88 feels a little high, honestly, with what he didn't play last year. Geno Atkins at an 88. Dang, he used to be so good, man. Now he's down to an 88, but it feels about right. And then Joe Mixon at an 89. Kind of underrated. I'd probably throw him at about a 90 or 91. And we got the Bills, Ed Oliver at an 81. I don't know what Ed Oliver did last year to really deserve an 81 overall card. He wasn't that great from what I saw, like, statistically wise and from watching Bills games. John Brown, 82, way underrated. He was very good last year. Mitch Morris, 82, feels about right. Devin Singletary, 82, feels about right. Jerry Hughes, 82, feels about right. Cole Beasley's not better than John Brown. Jordan Poyer, 85, feels right. Mike Hyde, 88, feels right. Tre'Davious White should be in 93. Stephon Diggs about 92 feels right, but Tre'Davious White had very similar stats to Stephon Gilmore, just wasn't quite as locked down. I think Tre'Davious White easily up there at 93-94. Denver Broncos, we got Bryce Callahan. He didn't play last year, so I'm not going to really judge him for that. We got Bradley Chubb, a little bit underrated. I still think he's a little bit overrated by Broncos fans, but still a not bad end right there. We got Cortland Sutton, 84. Feels about right. AJ Boye, 84 feels about right. Jarrell Casey, 84. A little bit underrated. I mean, he did only get traded for a 7th round pick, and he hasn't had great seasons recently, but still feels a little low. Melvin Gordon feels a little low, but he didn't play last year. Philip Lindsay, I would say Melvin Gordon's higher than Philip Lindsay any day. Kareem Jackson, way overrated. He's out of his prime. He's not that good anymore. Should be like an 83. Justin Simmons at a 90 feels about right, maybe a little higher. And then Von Miller at a 97 feels about right as well, but he should start to regress soon. He didn't have the best season last year, but he's still Von Miller. Moving on to the Browns, now this is where it gets interesting. We got Sheldon Richardson at 81. He's definitely higher than Olivier Vernon. Olivier Vernon was not good last year. Sheldon Richardson is better than Olivier. Jarvis Landry at 85 is robbing him. He had a very good season last year because of OBJ not having the best season. Jarvis Landry should be at least an 87. Joel Bitonio, one of the best guards in the league, should be way higher than an 86. I mean, he's up there with like Zach Martin and Ali Marpet up there with the best guards. Higher than that, Denzel Ward in 86, not the best year last year, but still a very good year in terms of Browns cornerbacks. Get him up maybe an overall or two. Kareem Hunt feels about right, maybe even a little high. Austin Hooper at 89 feels about right, maybe a 90 would be suitable. OBJ at a 91, his season last year wasn't great in OBJ terms, but it's still a good season, so I think maybe a little bit higher, but overall that's not bad. Nick Chubb at a 92, I like that rating for him, he's still up and coming. And then Myles Garrett at a 93 does feel a little low, but you know, the incident that happened last year. Understandable. For the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, we got Ryan Jensen. That feels about right, I guess. Shaq Barrett, way too low. He's better than Ndamukong Suh at this point in his career. Ndamukong Suh, I think, like, if you just switch them and put Shaquille Barrett like an 88, I think that's fine. Vita Vea, 87, feels a little high, but it's not bad. Chris Godwin, 87, feels about right. I mean, he's still proving himself a lot. He had a very good season last year, but I don't think he's quite earned the 90 overall quite yet, just because he hasn't been consistent. That was his first really good season. Then we got Ali Marpet, 89. Ali Marpet's not better than Joel Bitonio. Just gonna come out and say that. We got Tom Brady at a 90. It feels about right. Levante David at a 90. Feels a little high. Mike Evans at a 92. Honestly, feels a little low. Mike Evans is very underrated. And then Gronk, way too high. 90 at most. Way too high for a guy who didn't play last year. Don't deserve that high overall. Then we got the Cardinals. Kyler Murray at a 77. I think that feels about right. I mean, Kyler Murray, he had a pretty decent season last year. The only reason he won Rookie of the Year is because it was kind of him or Josh Jacobs, and quarterbacks normally win it. I think Josh Jacobs was well more deserving, but definitely not bad. We got Christian Kirk at 78. Not bad. I think that's about fair. Isaiah Simmons at a 78. That's pretty dang good for a rookie. Byron Murphy at an 80. Feels a little bit high. And then we got Kenyon Drake at an 82, which feels a little low. Kenyon Drake had a really good season last year on the Cardinals. Larry Fitz at an 83 feels about right. Buda Baker at an 86 feels about right. 88, Pat Pete had a down season last year. Didn't play much. Feels about right. Chandler Jones at 95. Too low, man. Chandler Jones has been underrated his entire career, and he's finally getting some recognition. Still feel like a 95 is not enough, man. He should be at least... He's on Von Miller's level at this point, which... Seems like a lot, but he had like 19 sacks last year. He was insane. He was up there with Shaq Barrett at the top of the sack list, but he's been so consistent through his career. This is well deserved for him, but I still think he deserves like a 97. And then D-Hop at a 98. It feels about right. Not quite a 99, I don't think. And then we got the Chargers who... Oops, I just dropped my controller. We got the Chargers with Austin Eckler at an 85. Feels about right for Austin Eckler. We got Hunter Henry at an 85. That's about right. Hunter Henry didn't really play much last year. He's been very injury prone his whole career, and he's never really been amazing. He's been a very good run blocker, I know that, but that's really it. Desmond King at an 88 is way, way too high, man. I don't know about that, man. Desmond King, I mean, he had an okay season last year, but he wasn't anything crazy. We got Brian Bulaga at an 88. Feels a little high for the veteran, but I mean, not too bad, I guess. Melvin Ingram is one of the better ends in the league. It definitely should be higher than Brian Bulaga overall-wise. Derwin James should be higher than an 89, but he was injured last year, so I understand that. Chris Harris had a little bit of a down season last year, so 89 works for me. Casey Hayward at about 90 feels about right as well. Joey Bosa at a 91. Feels a little low, but it's not too bad. And then Keenan Allen at a 91 feels about right for him as well. And sorry if you can hear my clicking of my mouse, just, you know. Going through these names, we got Sammy Watkins at an 81 for the Chiefs. Feels about right for Sammy. Been on the up and up ever since the Super Bowl in the playoffs. Harrison Butker, I think that's well deserved. One of the better kickers in the league. Damian Williams, I feel like that's a little high. He did have a good Super Bowl, but other than that, I feel like him and Sammy Watkins should be about the same. Frank Clark at an 83 feels a little low because Frank Clark is pretty dang good, but I understand him. Chris Jones, well deserved with a 92. Tyrann Mathieu with a 93, well deserved. He's finally getting some recognition. He played so well last year. Tyreek at a 96 feels a little high. I think I put him at about 94, but that's just me. Mitch Schwartz at a 96, definitely correct. One of the best right tackles in the league, if not the best. Travis Kelce at 97, about right. As long as George Kittle's higher than him, I'm fine with that rating. And then Patrick Mahomes at a 99. Way too high. Patrick Mahomes should be at 40 overall, obviously. But no, Patrick Mahomes, well deserving. Of that, and then you got that $500 million contract. That's insane. Then we got the Colts, who's got Phillip Rivers at an 82. I think that's about right. I mean, I feel bad because he was really good last year. Not last year, the year before that. I mean, he had a really good card. He was like a 94, and he dropped down to an 82. I think he's a little bit low, but he did have a bad season last year. Then we got Malik Hooker. That's about right for him. Darius Leonard, way underrated. Darius Leonard is one of the best pass rushing. Gosh, I'm stupid. If he was one of the best coverage linebackers last year up there with, like, Anthony Barr, Demario Davis, just some of the best in the league at that position. Marlon Mack should not be an 85. He's way overrated. He should be 82 at most. Justin Houston, 85. Feels about right. Ryan Kelly, an 85. Feels about right. Anthony Costanzo, a little high for the veteran, but not bad. DeForest Buckner feels way too low at an 87. He's one of the best deep tackles in the league. 87 feels way too low. We got T.Y., 87. Feels about right. Hadn't played a bunch last year. Didn't play great. Feels good. Quentin Nelson should be in 97, 98. I mean, he's the best guard in the league, best offensive lineman in the league. I think the heat is way too low for Quentin Nelson. Maybe it's a little premature to say that, but he's just been so good. His first 2 years, Pro Bowler, All Pro, first team. He's been insane. And then we got Dallas Cowboys, Leighton Vander Esch, 83. Feels a little low. Definitely should be higher than Chidobe Awuzie. Dak at an 84, I think that's fair. I want to see where they put Wentz, if they're going to have Dak at an 84. Joel McCoy, 85, feels fair. Lael Collins at an 87, feels a little high. I think Leighton Vander Esch is better than Lael Collins overall-wise, but I think that's fair. DeMarcus Lawrence at an 89 feels fair. Tyron Smith at a 91 feels fair. Mari Cooper and Zeke and a 92 feels fair, and then Zach Martin and a 98. A little bit overrated, because like I said, I like Quentin Nelson a little more than Zach Martin, but I wouldn't hate on that rating because Zach Martin is definitely a top three offensive lineman, top two guard. Then we got the Dolphins, who got Albert Wilson at a 76. Overrated. Albert Wilson's not that good. We got Devon Godshaw. This feels about right for him. Raekwon McMillan, about right for him. Matt Breida, about right for him as well. Mike Gesicki, way underrated. He's one of my favorite young tight ends in the league. I think he's going to have a breakout year, very similar to Darren Waller this year. He's going to be good. Jordan Howard, feels about right. Xavien Howard, way too low for one of the highest paid corners in the league. He wasn't playing last year just because of they put him on IR and a different bunch of different stuff happened with him. He's underrated. He will prove people. He had a lot of interceptions a couple years ago, and I think he's going to do really well this year. Devontae Parker, way underrated. One of the better receivers in the league, and that's way underrated for sure. Kyle Vannoy feels a little high, but I guess 86 isn't bad. And then Byron Jones at 88 feels about right. Maybe a little higher than 90 would be nicer, but definitely not too bad there. We got the Eagles with Nickell Robey-Coleman, 83. Feels a little high, but not too bad. Alshon Jeffrey, 84 feels about right. So we got Carson Wentz and Dak both being at an 84. I like that. I feel like the debate there, they are very similar in their skill level, I feel like. And I would say I have Dak higher, but I think Carson Wentz and him being the same overall is fine with me. Darius Slay, 87, way too low. Brandon Graham, 87, feels about right. I think Darius Slay should at least be a 90. Lane Johnson, 89, low. One of the best right tackles in the league, up there with Mitchell Schwartz. Zach Ertz at a 90 feels about right. Not the best season last year, but still one of the better tight ends in the league. Brandon Brooks at a 93. Hope he makes it through that Achilles tear, but still definitely up there with the better guards in the league. Jason Kelce at 94, probably the best center in the league. Definitely deserving of the 94. And then Fletcher Cox at the 96. Probably one of the best, if not the best, D-tacks in the league. Well-deserving. Unless you consider Aaron Donald a D-tackle, then he's obviously better. But Fletcher Cox, well-deserving of the 96 overall. Then we got the Falcons with Dante Feller at 81. Feels a little high, but didn't have a bad season last year. Ricardo Allen at 81. Feels about right. Calvin Ridley at 83. I gotta see where they put DJ Moore, because if they put Calvin Ridley higher than DJ Moore, maybe it's my Panthers bias, but DJ Moore had over 1,000 yards last season. He had a bunch of touchdowns with, our quarterback. I can't remember our quarterback last year. Kyle Allen. That's what his name was. Yeah, Kyle Allen at the quarterback. You deserve some credit with him at your quarterback. And then McCaffrey running the offense. But we got Keanu Neal in 84. Didn't really play last year, but it feels about right. Deion Jones in 86. Maybe a little higher, but feels about right. Todd Gurley in 86. Feels about right for Todd Gurley. Got to prove himself this year. And Matt Ryan, 87, feels about right. Alex Mack should be higher. One of the better centers in the league. Always just a Pro Bowler. Feels like he should be higher. Grady Jarrett, 90. Feels about right. And then Julio at a 96. Well deserved for Julio. I still think Julio's better than... I still think Julio's the best receiver in the league. I think he should be a 99. I think D-Hop at a 98 is right. And then MT at like a 96 would be fair. But we'll see where Michael Thomas is. We got 49ers with Raheem Mostert in 84. That's fair. Raheem Mostert had a very good season last year. Mike McGlinchey in 85. Pretty good. One of the better up-and-coming tackles. D Ford feels about right for him. Kyle Juszczyk, way underrated fullback. Even though he's the best in the league, I feel like 86 is not quite high enough. Eric Armstead, 86 feels about right. Fred Warner, 87 should be higher. One of the better coverage outside linebackers, like I said, up there with Darius Leonard, Demario Davis, Anthony Barr, up there with those guys. We got Nick Bosa at 89, feels about right. Richard Sherman, 92, I think that's about right. Trent Williams on the 49ers, I forgot he did get traded there. Trent Williams, I think that's pretty fair at a 92, maybe a little lower because of him missing last season, but not bad. And then George Kittle higher than Travis Kelce, agree with that, the 98. I honestly think he might deserve the 99, but that's all my opinion. We got the Giants, James Bradbury. He's way underrated, man. He was very good on the Panthers last year, and he's one of the better corners in the league when it comes to just playing small and playing fast. I think that's what James Bradbury really thrives in. We got Dalvin Tomlinson at 80. Well-deserved. Jabril Peppers, I think he's a little underrated. Maybe a little higher for Jabril Peppers. Leonard Williams about an 80. Feels about right. Sterling Shepard in 82. A little high, but not too bad. Golden Tate in 84. Feels too high. Didn't have a great season last year. I think him and Sterling Shepard are about even at this point. Kevin Zeitler, 85. Feels about right. Not the best season last year, but still one of the better guards in the league. Evan Ingram, 88. Well-deserved. He's a very good tight end for sure. Up there with some of the best. And then Saquon at a 91. Feels a little low, but he did miss a lot of last season. He had not the greatest year, but a decent year for sure. So I think a little low, maybe a 93, 94 feels better, but not bad there. Then we got the Jags, who don't have a lot of good talent. We got Dede Westbrook at 79. Feels about right. DJ Chark at 81. Feels about right. Josh Allen at 81. Feels about right. Miles Jack, 81. Feels about right. Josh Schobert's way underrated. I'm still a huge Josh Schobert fan. he's way underrated, man. One of the best. Just, he reminds me a lot of young Luke Kuechly, and I think his ceiling is honestly to become the next Luke Kuechly. He is very good. I think he has a skill set to become someone like Luke Kuechly. Andrew Norwell in 83 feels right. Leonard Fournette feels right. Yannick Ngakoue, a little bit low. He shouldn't just be down because he needs a trade. Josh Lambeau, one of the better kickers in the league, feels about right. And then Brandon Linder, one of the better centers in the league, feels about right. Now, moving on to the Jets, Brian Winters, Frank Gore, feel about right. Jameson Crowder, Brian Poole. Brian Poole is definitely very underrated. He deserves to be higher, but Jameson Crowder feels about right. Marcus May, about right. Pierre Desir, not better than Brian Poole. Avery Williamson, not bad in 83, feels about right. CJ Mosley, a little low at 85. Le'Veon Bell, a little overrated at 87. Jamal Adams should be at 97. One of the probably best safety in the league up there with Derwin and stuff. Then we got the Lions, Matt Prater. He's a little overrated at this point in his career, not the best kicker. Kerryon Johnson, a little high, but I mean, actually, that's about right. Frank Ragnow, about right. Jamie Collins, about right. Matt Stafford, way too low. He's better than Wentz and Dak, to my opinion. Desmond Trufant feels about right for him. Justin Coleman, way too high for Justin Coleman. Marvin Jones Jr., one of the better receivers in the league, and one of the better number two receivers in the league. Not bad, though. Trey Flowers, 86, feels about right. And Kenny Golladay, way too low at 86. Not much I could really say there. I don't want to spend too much more time on these because I know the video is already getting pretty long, so we'll go kind of fast. Elgton Jenkins, 80 fair. Preston Smith, a little low. Adrian Amos, feels about right. Za'Darius Smith, a little low. A-Rod, feels about right. Jair, way too high. Aaron Jones, about right. Kenny Clark, about right. Devontae Adams, about right. And then Dave Bakhtiari, about right. Best left tackle in the league. McCaffrey, 99, too low. Then we got Trey Boston at 79. I like that rating. Graham Gano, 79. He missed all last season. I think he'll come back and have a nice season. Taylor Moten, at an 80, feels about good. Curtis Samuel feels pretty good at an 80. Matt Paradis had a down season last year, but still not bad. Dante Jackson, one of the better young corners in the league. I like him a lot. Robbie Anderson, I think he's well deserved the 84. DJ Moore, I think that's higher than Calvin Ridley at 83, so I like that. And then Kwon Jordan at 87. Patriots, we got Jonathan Jones at 83. I think that's fair. Patrick Chung at 83. Overrated, he's old. David Andrews is 84. I like that. Jason McCourty at 85. Overrated, old. Joe Tooney, 85. Feels about right. Shaq Mason, 86. Feels about right. Julian Edelman, 86. Feels about right. Dante Hightower, 88. Feels about right. Devin McCourty at a 92. Feels about right. And then Stephon Gilmore at a 99. Obviously, part of the 99 club, feels about right. Gabe Jackson, feels about right, actually. Derek Carr, I mean, that's fair for Derek Carr. Tyrell Williams, overrated, not that good. Marcus Joyner, I think that's about right. Demaryius Randle's about right. Darren Waller, way too low. Trent Brown, seems about right. Josh Jacobs, about right. Richie Incognito, way overrated. And then Rodney Hudson at 93, feels about right. We got Samson Ebukam for the Rams, 80 overall, feels about right. Tyler Higbee, overrated. Shouldn't be that high. Michael Brockers, 83, feels a little high. John Johnson, feels about right. Andrew Whitworth, feels about right. Robert Woods, feels right. Johnny Hecker, feels right. Cooper Kupp, a little low. Jalen Ramsey, feels about right. And Aaron Donald, feels about right. I'm just kind of curious how many teams we have left. We have quite a few teams left. That's interesting. And then we move on to the Ravens. We've got Sam Cook at 85. One of the better punters in the league, feels right. Mark Andrews, one of the better tight ends in the league, way underrated, should be higher. Mark Ingram, feels about right. Brandon Williams, feels about right. Justin Tucker, they don't rate kickers and punters high in this game, so that's fine. Earl Thomas, seems a little low, but not bad. Marlon Humphrey, feels about right. Ronnie Stanley, about right. Lamar Jackson, way too low. Calais Campbell, way too high. Lamar Jackson should easily be higher than Calais Campbell. We got the Redskins, or maybe the Redskins now, but not for much longer. We got Landon Collins at 81, feels about right. Darius Geis, about right. Terry McLaurin, way too low. Jonathan Allen, about right. Tress Way, about right. Deron Payne, about right. Ryan Kerrigan, everything I would say here is about right. Brandon Scherff, maybe a little underrated, but the whole Redskins feels pretty good except for Terry McLaurin. I would say he needs to be higher. Saints, we got Lattimore at 86, Jared Cook, Emmanuel Sanders at an 87. I put Marshawn better than Emmanuel Sanders. Alvin Kamara in 88 feels good. Demario Davis in 89. Ryan Ramchick in 91. Drew Brees in 93. Teron Armstead in 95. Cam Jordan in 96. And Michael Thomas in 98. I like these rankings a lot. I think it fits pretty well. Like I said, Marshawn Lattimore may be higher than these two, but other than that, feels about right. Seattle Seahawks, we got Quandre Diggs. Had a very underrated season last year. Feels about right in an 80, maybe a little higher. Carlos Hyde, I didn't even know he was on the Seahawks. I think that's fair. KJ Wright, maybe a little higher. He had an underrated season as well. Shaquille Griffin, feels about right. Dwayne Brown, too high. Chris Carson, a little low, but still not one of the... he's still a little overrated, I would say. Greg Olson, feels about right. Tyler Lockett, way underrated, should be a little higher. Russell Wilson, Bobby Wagner, both feel about right. Honestly, Bobby Wagner should be a 99. Then we got the Steelers. Alejandro Villanueva, about right. Joe Hayden, about right. Ebron, about right. TJ Watt should be a 95. Juju feels about right. Marquise Pouncey feels about right. Stephon Tuitt feels right. Minka Fitzpatrick should be higher. Cam Hayward, fine. DeCastro, fine. TJ Watt needs to be way higher. Way higher for TJ Watt. Texans, we got Duke Johnson, 81. Little overrated, but not bad. Kenny Stills, he just got arrested, so I'm not sure if he's going to even play much this season. We got Whitney Merciless, feels about right. Will Fuller, overrated. Bernard McKinney feels about right. Justin Reed feels about right. Tunsil feels right. Brandon Cooks feels right. Watson feels low. And then J.J. Watt feels a little high, but still one of the better ends, or I guess you could say defensive ends in the league. And then we got two teams left. We got the Titans with Ben Jones at an 80. Throughout right, A.J. Brown should be higher. One of the better rookie receivers up there with Terry McLaurin. Jonathan Joseph feels about right. Harold Landry, 82, feels a little high. Roger Saffold, I like him at that position. Adoree Jackson feels good. Taylor Lewan at 84 is good. Brett Kern, one of the better punters in the league. Ken Byard, a little bit overrated, and then Derrick Henry should be higher than a 93, maybe 95, but overall still good. Then we got Anthony Barr at an 82, too low. Kirk Cousins, 82, I think he's too low. Anthony Harris, 83, feels about right. Kyle Rudolph, feels about right, 84. Daniel Hunter, 89, and Eric Kendricks at an 89, both feel about right. Adam Thielen, 90, a little low, but not bad. Michael Pierce feels about right at 91. Dalvin Cook, a little low at a 91, and then Harrison Smith, a little bit high at a 95. But yeah, guys, that is gonna be the video. I've been talking for a long time straight now. Those were all the 10 best players on each team in Madden 21 overall wise. And yeah, guys, that's the video. I hope you guys did enjoy the video, and if you did, make sure to drop a like down below and subscribe when nobody's on. But yeah, I'll see you boys in the next one. Peace out.